Hello everyone, in today's video we'll talk about the payroll statements. So before we proceed to the practical part, so let's understand what is the payroll statement is all about. So payroll statement is basically a salary statement. So salary has two components, that is the gross and the deduction. So when we talk about the gross, so gross includes the various components like basic pay, DNS allowance, transports allowance and HRA and so on, and deduction include like TDS, contribution towards provident funds and so on. So if we deduct all the deduction from the gross, we arrive at net salary. So in today's video we'll understand the calculation of various components of salary. So let's start with the question. Now you can see here in this question it is given that ABC Limited paid to its employees the salary on the basis of the category, and the gross salary of employees consists of basic salary plus DNS pay, DA, HRA, TA and CCA, and the GPF and IT are the two deduction, and the components of salary are computed according to these services. So the rules for payment for basic salary, TA, CCR is under. So there are three category A, B, C. If the employee belongs to category A, he will be entitled to basic salary of this and TA this and CCA this. In the same way for B and C category respectively. And rules for DP, DA, HRA, RS under. So we have given the various conditions for calculating the different components of gross. And so we also given the rules for the deduction also. As we know in this question there are two deduction, that is the GPF and IT. And so you are required to prepare a payroll statement in a suitable format making use of cell referencing facility. The one more point here you have to note it down here, whenever we prepare the payroll statement it should be fully generalized. So we have to make use of self-referencing facility. So before we start with the question, in order to simplify our calculation we will make this table, and this is given in the question. We have given the different category of the employees and the basic salary and TA and CCA. And if we talk about the format of payroll statement, so the format of payroll statement is like this. So this is the name of the employees. So I have taken the 10 employees, and this is the category from like they are belong to that particular category. So this is I have taken randomly, and we have noted down all the components of the salary. Now we'll proceed to the calculation of the basic salary. Now we first will calculate the basic for the employee 1, and the she belongs to the category A, and we have given this table. So in order to simplify our work I'll be using the VLOOKUP. So we look up this category from this table, and this table is fixed. So this is the column number 1, this is the column number 2. So I want to write the value of the column number 2, so I need to write it to here, then enter. So you can see here the value is automatically come. So now you can check here if she belongs to category B, the amount basic of changes to 20,000 from 25,000, and in case of C is 15,000. So in this way we'll calculate the basic salary. Now for the DP, we have the condition that if basic salary is more than 25,000 then 50% else 45%. So we're going to apply the if formula here. So is equals to if basic is more than 25,000 then it will be 50% of basic, otherwise it will be 45% of basic. So in this way we'll calculate the DP for the first employees, and if you drag it to the other cell the values are, you can see here it is coming automatically. Now we need to calculate the DA. Now the condition for DA is that if total of basic plus DP is more than 30,000 and 40% else it will be 30% of basic. So again I am going to use the if function here, is equals to if, and if the basic salary plus DNS pay is more than 30,000 then it will be 40% of basic, otherwise it will be 30% of basic. Fine. So this is the formula for DA. If basic plus DP is greater than 30,000, and it will be 40%, otherwise it will be 30%, then okay, I need to put one last bracket here. So if I drag it to the other cell, so you can see here the values is coming. Now we need to calculate the CCA. Now CCA is already given in this table, so I can apply the VLOOKUP function here. So again VLOOKUP. So we want to look up the value of this category from this table, which is going to be fixed. Then the column number will change. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we want the value of the column number 4. So bracket close and enter. And if you drag it to the other cell, you will get the values in other column. Now we need to calculate the TA. So again I am going to use the same formula here. That is the VLOOKUP. So this category from this table, again it is fixed, so we need to press F4, and now the column number will change to 3. So in this way we will be getting the value of the TA and will drag it. Now we need to calculate the HRA. So for HRA, the condition is if basic is greater than 20,000 or TA is greater than 4,000, then he will be getting the 30% of basic plus DP plus DA, otherwise it will be 0. So again we need to apply the if function here, but here there are two conditions which has to be true. That is, the basic should be greater than 20,000 and TA is greater than 4,000, and we need to apply the OR function also. So I am going to use if and OR again. So if OR, first condition is basic is greater than 20,000. So this basic is greater than 20,000. This is my first condition. Second is TA should be greater than 4,000. So I need to select the TA cell and it should be greater than 4,000. So this is my two condition. If one of the condition is true, then he will be getting the 30% of basic plus DP plus DA. So here I am simply plus all this value. You can simply use the sum function also. It will give you the same answer. So if this, either one of the condition is satisfied, he will be getting this percent of salary. Otherwise it will be 0. Then enter. So if you drag it, you can see here the values are coming. So in case of category B, it is coming out to be 0. So what are the two conditions? That the basic salary should be more than 20,000. So here it is 20,000, and the TA is also more than 4,000. So that is 4,000. So that means both the condition are false. That's why it is giving the 0 value. Now we need to calculate the gross. So gross is simply the sum of all the components. So we'll add all these values and we'll arrive at gross, and we will drag it to the other cell. Now we need to calculate the income tax. So the condition for the income tax that we have given, that is at 8% of gross. So 0.08 multiplied by this amount. So you will be getting the income tax amount, and you can drag it for the others. Now we need to calculate the PF. The condition for the PF is 10% of basic. So is equals to 10% of basic, then enter, and you can drag it to the other cell. Now how do we calculate the net? So net simply equals to gross minus income tax minus PF, then enter. So in this way we'll arrive at net salary of the employees. For the others you can simply drag it. So I hope this simple problem is clear to all of you. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. So if you like this video, please do like and subscribe the channel. So thank you so much.